All right, round two. No lander here, so easy mulligan decision. And this hand's not great, but it's a keep. So read the bones. I'm gonna bottom that. It might be a little slow with this hand. We're just looking for Forsaken Sanctuary as a start. Something that lets us curve three, four, five. Looks like we're playing against green white. Yep. Well, we're getting lamb halted. Yep. Bad news for us. Probably gonna have to unmake the pacifist. Yeah. Hoping for no Nissa here as a follow-up. No Nissa, no Gideon. Sometimes you lose every time. Pretty sure I still have to fire it off on the Butcher instead of the Nissa, which is opposite of what I want to do. Maybe I don't have to do that. Huh. Maybe I can blast the Nissa? No. Well, so yeah, I think I have to do with the play that protects Gideon the best. This feels real bad, but if I just keep taking four every turn, I don't think I'm going to be able to win. We just have to hope there's no Gideon here. But like, okay, hanger for two, yeah. So it's gonna be a lot better for us. Could have been Gideon. Hanger for two, I can maybe beat. Although this does look pretty bad, still. Probably gonna need a languish at some point to clean up this mess. Maybe an Archangel Avacyn this turn. What is this? Secure? No, another hanger. Hanger then minus. No, just making a plant. Okay. Going for ultimate. Six. Which means our Sorin should be able to get to it. If we draw a land, our Sorin should be able to get to this before it ultimates. So that's good. Assuming we draw the land. So we do have a plan to win this game. Not a good one, but we have a plan. Which is take this Nissa out with Sorin. Okay. Shambling Vent. Well, here goes. Untap land. Oh, that's probably the ball game. We did not draw the land. Nissa is going to ultimate. Tilt. Secure the Waste and Fortified Village. Well, Secure the Waste is also gonna just kill us. I don't know why our opponent didn't play Fortified Village. Played one of these lands instead. I don't know. Well, okay, just not even gonna cast the Secure. Okay. I guess that's good. I mean, I can maybe win through drawing seven cards. Gaining seven life. Seems unlikely, but stranger things have happened. Really? Oh, beautiful. Not going for the ultimate, I love it. Okay, no reason to fire anything off. Now, I might just be dead to this Westville Abbey, though. In fact, I believe that I'm dead to the Westville Abbey. Let's see if there's a way I can not be dead to it. So, Soren can gain me 6 life. Dinging this for 6. Abby's gonna transform. Sacrificing 2 hangar backs. Just 1 hangar. Yeah, 2 hangar backs. And get 8 Thopters. And then that plus a Nissa minus is certainly game. Maybe I have to send Gideon. Maybe I have to get aggressive on this Nissa. Alright, we'll start by drawing and losing a life and seeing where that takes us. Ruinous Path. Wow. Okay. So now I'm dead if my opponent goes for Ormondal, but opponent doesn't know that. So let's just put another knight into play. Cast Without Awaken on Nissa. I'm actually getting pretty close here to being able to make my own. So if our opponent doesn't kill us, then I certainly have a fighting chance. So if Ormondal doesn't get made, basically. Okay, that's a bad first start. Anguish Unmaking is an answer to Ormondal, but opponent does not know if we have it or not. Okay. Well, maybe it comes at a Planeswalker. Where's that fortified village? Gideon? Yep. Emblem, probably. Wow. Okay. Okay, well, this gives me a chance. Fortunately, I can't ultimate price any of these stupid things. I can actually ultimate price this, but it's indestructible. Okay, Covenant Ob. Okay, so plant's really the only thing I can kill with the price. Okay, I can't block. I don't think I want to spend the price, so just untap and draw planes. Okay. So Transgress is gonna miss because it's secure the waste as the card in hand. Now if I tap out for Sorin, our opponent knows the coast is clear. But I don't really know what else I'm gonna be doing, so we'll just make the play. I'm one short of being able to make my own Westfell Abbey, which would have been able to one creature short of being able to block this thing. Okay. Let's see. We lost game one to green white tokens, so what comes in and out? So the sweepers I think are fine. I don't think Obnixilis is good. Ultimate Prize certainly was not good. And I don't know about Transgress the Mind. Now I do like Duress though. I do like Hallowed Moonlight. I do like Grasp of Darkness. I like all of these cards. So now I want Displacer because it's really good against green white. And I don't think I want Kalatos. Maybe the Linvala. The thing about Transgress is it's, I don't know, it's good and it's bad. It misses a lot of cards. Yeah, I think I'd rather just have some Duresses. Like, we saw Transgress be pretty bad in that game. Don't think that I want Thought Not Seer. I do think I want Linvala, though. Just a big flyer. Especially with Displacer. Alright. We give it a shot. I don't know how good Languish is against green white. It would have been quite good that game, though. Well, keeping it and hoping to draw Gideon. Grasp of Darkness. Okay. If I draw another black source now, I can kill something like a turn, like a Lamholt Pacifist. Why did it have to actually be a Lamholt Pacifist? And I don't want to blow Anguish Unmaking on this thing again. I want to save it for a Planeswalker. But we're taking a big beating from this thing again. Much as I would like to read the bones, I don't have much of a voice. Gonna do this now so that Dromoka's command isn't a possibility. Another pass first, okay. Okay, I don't mind how that played out. Do I want a duress before it bones? Probably. Probably not, actually. We'll read the bones first, see what I want. Languish in a swamp. So I have Planar Outburst, makes me not really want the Languish. I think I just want, like, Planeswalkers. Hallowed Moonlight. Well, let's go ahead and Duress. See what we got to deal with. Okay, so there's a Nissa that's castable. So there's two Den Protector. I wish I kept that Languish. So there is a Dromoka's command. Good to know. And there's a Gideon and a Nissa. Now, I think I'd rather have to deal with a Nissa. So I'll take the Gideon. Yeah, take the Gideon. I kind of want to save this planar. I'm at 5 lands here. I kind of want to save this planar outburst until I can awaken. Like, awakening on this shambling event seems pretty good. Alright, so there's the Westfield Abbey. Means opponent could cast the Gideon, can attack, and just says go. Okay, so that's gonna flip. Another Moonlight. Well, I guess I just have to say go here. I'm gonna be taking a hit from that Butcher, but I don't really know what other options I have. I'd rather not just double Moonlight on my turn for no reason. Alright. That means I will be taking 4. No play. Well, I guess I make a cleric. I could play these Moonlights. Might be better. Ooh, Gideon, that's a good draw. And now I'm set up pretty well. Dromoka's command can take out one of these creatures, but I get to block the other one. Doesn't even cast the command, okay. Let's see what this is gonna be. Skid. Throw the human cleric under the bus. Keep this Gideon alive, because Gideon's going to have to go all the way. There's a morph. The Den Protector. Alright, let's just get one of these Moonlights gone. Draw a card. I would like to be able to overload this outburst. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Guess we'll awaken Shambling Mint. Blow everything away. Blow it all up. Probably getting back the Gideon, maybe? Yeah. And how do I want to do this? Kinda just want to attack for 5, but I think I'll just make a knight. Play a little bit more conservatively. I think I'm still trying to win a longer game, so hitting for 5 to put our opponent to 15 doesn't accomplish a whole lot. Maybe it, because I have this giant shambling event, it's fine. Alright, so there's another 10 protector. Duress, not bad. So there's a den protector, another den protector. So there's a lot of den protectors in this deck. Now what am I taking? Tremocus Command maybe? No, I think it's Gideon again, actually. Yeah, I'll take the Gideon. So here, yeah, I'll just actually get a little aggro. And now I have the Unmaking and a Hallowed Moonlight up, which is pretty good. And I could actually activate the Shilling Vent and make it 6 power, but then I wouldn't have Moonlight and Unmaking available to cast. Can also activate a Westfell Abbey to make a token too. So. Okay. Pretty content to just let Gideon take some damage. My goal with Gideon is just to keep bashing for 5. So if it's something like Nissa, I get to Moonlight it. Unmaking anything else. Nothing. Okay. Land's good. Alright, I guess I'll just crash in with a team. It's either Avacyn or, no matter what it is, I have it covered. Unless it's just a straight removal spell. No, okay. Okay. So let's see if there's anything I learned from that game. Maybe Deadweight's good because of the Den Protectors, but probably not. Sweepers are definitely good. I don't think that. Well, maybe, like. Maybe this card's good? It's bigger than, like, Den Protectors and stuff? Oh no. Certainly doesn't seem good to me. Yeah, I'll stick with the plan. We'll stick with this. Okay, this is a keep. Not an exciting hand, but it's definitely a keep. Actually, this hand's not too bad. Ooh, another duress. Well, if we had had a basic swamp, this would be great. Could just duress on turns 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Leap. Gross. Yeah, I would have liked to duress that. At least I can maybe unmaking it. Okay, so there's a vista, a plains, a lamb, and a hanger. Leap's gonna do some dirty things. Okay, we didn't know about that forest, so it's a new one. Gross. Okay, we needed to draw the land there, which we did not do. And I could have cast these other duresses are bad because our opponent just doesn't have any spells in their hand. Okay, and they hit Lamholt Pacifist. So another Lamholt in hand. There it is. So we know two of the three cards are Canopy Vista and Hangerback. Well, I guess I have to cast Duress. Maybe I'll get a hit now. Another Lamholt. I'm still in this game. If I can draw a land, I can unmaking Evolutionary Leap. And then play Gideon, and then play Languish. Alright, Lamholt's flipping. Okay, there's the land. I guess we'll try Duress one more time. And Avacyn. Ugh! Gross. Okay. This has been a bad game. Not drawing lands has been the death of us. Lamholtz. Lands. Okay. Well, I get to survive. Not good, but I get to survive. Our opponent gets to restock three creatures. And one of them's a Den Protector. Oh, it doesn't reveal it to us. Gross. Okay, so Den Protector still have an Advocate. And Den Protector. Two Den Protectors and a Sylvan Advocate. And then the Hangerback Walker we already knew about. And Gideon. Okay, so what are my options? Play my own Gideon. I could unmaking or ruinous path this Gideon, probably just ruinous path it. But that puts me pretty far behind. I think I'm just gonna play my own Gideon and just put something into play. And now my Gideon's gonna die if our opponent sends it all at it, but then I get to untap and maybe have like Ruinous Path plus Anguished Unmaking and this Knight token. And maybe try to build back from that. So let's see where these are going. Gideon, and at me. Smarts. Alright, I don't think I can block here. I just have to take the damage. Because I need this token to be able to maybe block something big on the following turn. Okay, draw. Languish. Well, I have to read them. Because I need to draw the land for Ruinous Path. Land and Sorin. Well, Sorin is a potential out. So, Sorin can kill Sylvan Advocate and gain me some life. Well, if we can get Leap off the board. Okay. Bad news bears for me. And this means I'm dead, right? Yeah. There's a minus involved. Okay. And we got slain pretty bad. So this black-white deck has not been very impressive this far. I don't know if our draws have been bad or what, but I mean, our draw was pretty bad this game, but still, it seemed like this green-white deck just had a lot of tools to beat us, so far I've not been terribly impressed with black-white, but we'll keep battling and see if we can maybe turn things around.